What's up, everyone? I'm Chris. We got Steph behind the camera,
and we're hungry to travel.
We are in Iloilo to continue our food tour of the city, and we're kicking it all off right here in the very historic neighborhood of Molo. Are you hungry? We are starving. Let's get eating. Sings pancit molo. Now, pancit molo is a very popular dish here in Iloilo that actually originated here in the Molo neighborhood. And one of the most popular places to get pancit molo is Kapi Sings, which is just down the road, but they unfortunately only sell frozen takeaway now. So you can come over here to Lebo's Diner to try their pancit molo. So we have the pancit molo in its own little personalized pot here, as well as a fresh lumpia, vegetable lumpia, and a baked empanada. So this should be a good breakfast. We have our individual pot of pancit molo there. Oh, it smells so nice. It's pretty fun that you get your own personalized pot to spoon for yourself. Let's get all that in there. Ooh, nice pepper at the bottom there. So here we have our bowl of pancit molo, and what pancit molo is, it's actually similar to like a Chinese wonton soup, and even though the name is called pancit molo, there's not actually any pancit noodles in this dish. And each order, you get six of these little dumplings, wonton dumplings in there, so let's give one a try. And this nice chicken broth, it smells so good. Those are so meaty. The ground pork on the inside is nice and tender, and it has a bit of a savory sourness to it as well. That is delicious. And the broth, oh. It's like I'm eating a chicken noodle soup. It has such a nice, strong chicken broth flavor. Mmm. Goes perfectly with the wonton-like dumplings. And what actually makes this broth special is that there's pieces of shredded chicken in there as well. So it gives it a nice extra bit of chicken flavor. These little wonton dumplings are so nice. They're so tasty. And even though it's such a simple dish, it packs so much flavor in this little bowl of pancit molo here. This is good. Let's try our baked empanada here. Looks like we have chickpeas, a little bit of ground pork, raisins, potato, some pepper in there. You can really smell the red peppers on the inside here. The empanada is so soft. There's not a whole ton of ground meat in there actually, but it's got a nice potato and carrot filling, so it's more like a vegetable empanada. Mm. That's good. It goes well with pancit molo. And the last thing we have to try here is this fresh lumpia. You can see this paper-thin wrapping of the lumpia here, and let's see what's inside. Oh wow, look at that. And you can see all the ubud there, which is the coconut palm heart. This is a very interesting looking lumpia. Never had fresh lumpia that quite looked like this. There's such a strong garlic smell coming off of this lumpia as well, and it's literally falling apart, so. Mmm. Ooh. So garlicky. The coconut palm hearts, it reminds me almost like a radish, but nice and crunchy. Mmm. And a slight bit of meat in there. I think it's pork, but mostly it's just that coconut palm heart. Mmm. Super tasty as well. This whole breakfast has been pretty yummy. I have to say the best part is definitely the pancit molo with those dumplings. Mmm. A nice hearty start to the day here in the Molo neighborhood of Iloilo.
belly every day, and I cannot describe how nice it smells in here, but also how hot it is next to all this charcoal, which is like, at all this pork belly. Oh my god, I can't get over this. Of this piece of meat. You can see it's layered pork belly, and this skin on top looks so crispy, smells insane. And they were telling us, so limpo is marinated. It's a secret what theirs is marinated in, but it's a combination of soy sauce and different herbs and spices. Let's just get a nice big piece here.
It's like Jenga.
Look at that, it is. Oh, wow. So you can see it's cut it up into three different layers, and we've got some nice lean meat, layers of fat, and of course that crispy layer of skin on top. Just look at that, the fat underneath, the thick skin, and it's just bubbled with how it's been grilled on the charcoal. Just look at that. Look at how thick this is. All right. That skin is so crispy. Oh my gosh. And the flavor of the meat is really interesting because you can taste that marinade, and it does have a sourness from the vinegar. So it's quite different than any pork belly I've actually tried before because of that interesting marinade of the soy sauce, the vinegar most likely, and just all the different herbs and spices. But I can't get over this skin. So crispy and crunchy and fresh. That meat is lean, but the layers of fat in between as well just make it so juicy and tender. This is an incredible piece of pork belly. So we have two sauces to go with our limpo, cinnamac, which is vinegar soy sauce with some onions and chilies in it, as well as their special gravy. So I'm gonna give it a dip in first the cinnamac and get a taste. Look at that nice dark color. Oh, that is spicy. A serious kick to it. But the flavors of the vinegar and the soy sauce, really nice, very strong. But again, not spicy. That's really tasty. I'm gonna get a dip of this gravy. Oh, that's a thick gravy. Look at that. All right. Oh, interesting. It's a sweet gravy. It's cold and it's sweet. Almost reminds me of a flavor similar to an applesauce, to be honest with you. That's very interesting. Also goes well with it because those are such different sauces. In Canada, a lot of times actually we eat applesauce with pork. So that's an interesting combination. I quite like that. I just can't get over how crispy and perfectly cooked this skin is. Come here, like just listen to this. A It's like sticky with the fat underneath it, but just so flavorful. And that smokiness from the charcoal, is incredible. This Ramboy's that we're at is located in the heart of Molo neighborhood, and they actually cook limpo for a few of their different locations that are throughout the whole city. And for 399 pesos, you get a massive piece of pork belly. I just can't get over how big this is. And honestly, I have to say as well, since being in the Philippines, the Filipinos really know how to cook their pork to perfection. This is incredibly delicious, and I think we need an ultimate skin dip here. That was so delicious. While we were sitting inside, we could see it right across the road here from us. They're selling fresh BUKO juice that we just need to try. So come on, let's get some. Look at this. We love fresh coconut juice. Oh. So refreshing and sweet. This is just what we need on a hot day exploring today.
One thing that we've noticed with a lot of the parks here in Iloilo is that they all play music through all these speakers. It's like classical music too, so it's such a nice atmosphere, ambiance here in Iloilo. So we are here at Punan to try this chicken binakal. And this is Chef Christopher. This is his family's restaurant here. And he's gonna show us how they make this awesome, traditional, and very unique soup. So take
Hello,
it away.
Good afternoon, guys. Welcome to Punan.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having us here to show us how to make this chicken binakal.
Chicken binakal is chicken in coconut soup.
Chicken in coconut soup. Oh, wow. So this is gonna be tasty with that coconut meat I see here.
Oil first. Onion, get the bill first.
Saute the onion.
Yeah. We'll add the ginger.
Of course, the garlic. Garlic.
Yeah. So we have to saute it very well. Add the, I saute also the lemongrass.
Oh wow. Yeah. So it brings out the flavor.
Yeah. Native chicken.
So native chicken,
is so I'm using native chicken because of its natural flavor, stronger flavor than the caged chicken. We'll season it with salt, the pepper, traditionally the chicken pinakol is cooked in a bamboo or in coconut itself.
Oh wow, like inside the coconut itself.
Inside
oh wow.
You can add our chicken stock, BUKO juice. Just to give extra sweetness to the soup.
So like coconut juice. Wow.
We add the potatoes, carrots, the bell pepper. Add your BUKO meat.
Wow, look at that coconut meat.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. So the chicken binakal usually cooks for about 45 minutes to an hour, and they usually cook the chicken earlier. So we're gonna let this sit and cook, but we have a finished product right here. And look at this chicken binakal in the traditional coconut. Wow. That smells so amazing. So here is our chicken binnacle in this lovely coconut hair, and we were also given a lovely pomelo, cashew, and anchovy salad. This smells amazing, but I want to dig into this soup here, and I love how they serve it in the coconut. Okay, let's see what we got here. Ooh, look at that lemongrass that was sauteed up with the onions and the garlic and the ginger. Look at all this. You can see the potatoes and the lovely native chicken here. Oh, wow. You can see the color of the soup is nice and clear. Ooh, it has such a nice coconut and actually lemongrassy smell to it. Ooh, that is a strong flavor of lemongrass, actually. Ooh, that is delicious, but it's got a nice coconut aftertaste as well. It's super light too, the broth, because it's a clear broth and it's made with that coconut water. It's not a heavy broth. It's very, very liquidy, not thick at all, but it's got a nice chicken flavor too from this delicious native chicken. So fragrant with the ginger and the lemongrass and the garlic and just, it's like a chicken soup on like steroids with the coconut and the native chicken here. Oh, that's amazing. Look at the color of that chicken. So this is their native chicken, which is almost like a free-range chicken here in the Philippines. So tender, it just fell right off the bone there. The chicken is so juicy. When you bite into it, it explodes with that soup as well. Just all soaked up. And the chicken meat, oh, that is tasty. This coconut is so packed with ingredients and ooh, this is what I want. Look at that coconut meat there. So nice and fresh, that coconut. So juicy still, and even though it's a hot soup, I've never had hot coconut before, but that coconut is still so juicy and flavorful of that coconut meat flavor. And actually, the soup broth is a little bit sweet too from that coconut water and the coconut meat as well. Such a unique soup. And this chicken binnacle actually originated here on Panay Island, so this is such a awesome experience to get to try it. Here at Punat, in the coconut as well. And you also have the coconut meat of the coconut here, so you can just shave away some of the coconut meat of your bowl. That coconut is so good. You have the lid of the coconut here. Just look how much meat is still on there, on his hat there. So you can just add it into the soup or just eat it plain as well. Wow, look at that. Fresh coconut to go with our binnacle soup. Coconut heaven here. I want to try some of this pomelo and anchovy salad. All the pomelo there, and look at all of the anchovies as well, and the cashews. Wow. That is some different flavors between the slightly bitter pomelo and juiciness of the pomelo. I love the crunchiness of it from the cashews and the dried and maybe fried anchovies as well. That combination totally works. So Chef Christopher and his team here at Punat were so nice enough to let us try some of their local specialties here at Iloilo. So what we have here is an adobo stingray, but made with coconut milk. That smells really coconutty. As well as what we have here is imbao, which is a local kind of like a clam here in Iloilo. Look how orange this stingray is. The stingray is so meaty and soft, but that sauce, so coconutty, actually. And again, very strong taste of lemongrass, so such unique flavors here at Punat. And I really want to try these imbao here. Look how many little clams we have here. Looks like it's in a nice broth here with some spring onion, and wow, these look so juicy and delicious. Cheers. So meaty. They're huge, juicy on the inside. You can taste the freshness of the clams as well. Those are amazing, local Iloilo clams. Oh, Chef Christopher, everything is so delicious. Masarap.
Thank you.
it was amazing. And the binnacle was so unique, the flavors of the coconut and the coconut meat, the coconut water that's used to make it, just delicious. Oh, masarap. Thank you so much for the wonderful experience here. Definitely visit Punat for some unbelievable Iloilo Ilonggo food. Thank you so much.
Thank you guys.
Salamat po. Thank you.
We're here at Samurai Talabahan for talaba and baked scallops. Now, talaba are oysters. These are really popular here, especially in Iloilo. There's lots of oyster farms around, so they are very fresh and just something you have to try when you're here in the city. And we really couldn't deny getting some baked scallops as well, and I'm glad we did because these look and smell really good too.
Smells so buttery. So we have the talaba platter. We have steamed talaba, so steamed oysters, baked oysters, which is baked with, it looks like, cheese, butter, garlic, as well as spicy baked talaba. So we got ourselves an oyster feast here, as well as these delicious looking scallops
too.
Yeah,
this all looks really good.
This is a seafood platter.
Really, it really is, yeah. Quite literally.
So let's dig in.
Where should we begin? So we just made ourselves a dip to go with our oysters. That's really popular here in Iloilo, made with, well, yours has the sinimac, which is vinegar with garlic and chilies, as well as soy sauce. Mine is just the sinimac. Let's add a little bit of that to our oysters here.
Mabuhay.
Mabuhay.
They're so fresh. Ooh. Tasting. Oh.
That strong vinegar mine was. Spicy.
Yeah, the soy sauce is nice though. Here, mine doesn't have quite as much spice because you have the chilies in yours, but the oysters are so fresh and so meaty.
You're right, those are really plump and juicy. Those are nice, you can taste how fresh they are.
You can see how big the scallop meat is there. Just such big pieces of scallop in there.
Those
and
do.
Again, they smell so buttery.
Okay. There's a big scallop.
Wow. All I taste is butter and garlic.
Oh, those look really good.
But the scallop is not very chewy. Also, so fresh.
You can seriously smell the butter on these. I know I'm gonna love those, but I am going to jump ahead to these baked scallops here. Just look at these guys. With the cheese, butter, and the garlic on top. These look insane.
I'm gonna get this spicy talaba here. Baked as well, but looks fairly red with chili and spices, so.
All right.
Go at the same time, how
Should
about?
Do it? Should we do it? All right, cheers.
Cheers.
Oh. Okay, that cheese on top, it's actually not cheese. It's like a creamy cheese flavored, almost like a cream corn kind of taste that's buttery and garlicky. Oh, that's actually really good.
Yeah,
it's so good.
The spicy one is not too spicy, to be honest. It just has a hint of spice. It's more buttery, actually. So same with, like,
really?
Probably the cheesy one, the creamy one here.
That's interesting.
It's just baked with butter, so.
Because those do look super spicy.
They do look spicy, but surprisingly, not spicy at all, really. Oh, this smells like honey butter.
That's it. That's the flavor I'm trying to put my finger on. It's like honey butter.
Wow.
You're gonna love that.
These look amazing.
Cheers.
Cheers again.
Oh, you're right. Not too spicy. That's nice.
These are like honey butter baked oysters.
Right?
That's amazing. Have you ever had honey butter flavored chips, almonds, anything? That's what these taste like. Just super buttery and slightly sweet.
And that's like one of our favorite flavors.
That's amazing.
Up there with like coconut and such things. So nice to try these oysters here in Iloilo because they really are so fresh. You can just taste the freshness in them. They're really plump and juicy. And I honestly really like the plain ones, that are just steamed or parboiled with the cinnamon, because it's just, I don't know, there's just such a fresh plainness to them that's really nice with the vinegar. It just really brings out a lot of flavor to them. So honestly, any way you have them, these are delicious here.
And you always gotta have your ultimate talaba bite. The baked spicy, the baked honey butter, the steamed, as well as scallop on the top for good measure. Oh, ultimate bite. That's a lot of oyster.
I can smell all the flavors coming from you right now. Take of one of Iloilo's most famous dishes, bachoy.
The bihun?
Yes, the bihun. The pork? The liver.
Pork liver.
Yeah, pork liver. Then the chicharron. And then the buko strips.
Oh, wow.
Then you have to put the fresh in. Garnish it with garlic and onion leaves.
We are here with our buko bachoy. Now there are a few things that are different with this bachoy than your typical bachoy. First of all, it's clearly in a coconut. We've also got coconut meat on top. Their broth they use here is half bachoy and half buko juice. Also, no shrimp paste, which you find in your typical bachoy. We got it with the bihun noodles. That's different than the miki, which are the thick egg noodles. There's also a raw egg on top. So this looks like it's gonna be a special treat. Let's break this raw egg first. Look at that. Just super creamy. We'll get it in the hot broth to kind of mix it and cook it a bit and get some of these ingredients mixed around. So there you see, there is just a ton of tasty stuff floating around here in this coconut. Let's get a nice big first bite here. Incredibly delicious. So different than the bachoy that we had the other day. The sweetness of the buko juice really adds so much flavor, as well as the buko meat itself. But then it's interesting because it's very savory still, with the bachoy broth being so rich with the beef and the pork. And then you have the soft pieces of pork and the liver in there, which gives it a good meatiness. And the chicharrons, which are kind of soft now, give a nice texture to it too. This is a really interesting take on bachoy. It's like a completely different dish, but so flavorful. I'm in love with this right now. Oh, that is so good. Masarap. Very delicious. And adding that raw egg on top is really nice because it just kind of disappeared into the broth, but gave it such a nice rich creaminess. And I love that we got these bihun noodles because they're nice and light compared to the typical egg noodles. And really, nothing beats eating anything out of a coconut. And as with every good bachoy place, you are given an extra serving of the hot broth to add into your soup to keep it nice and hot, especially because the coconut absorbs some of the heat. So let's add a little bit of this in. Oh yeah, I really love the use of the coconut meat in this dish too. It just adds so much flavor to it, and it just shows you how unique and interesting Ilonggo cuisine is. To be honest, today has been such a fantastic day, and we've tried some really different foods, and this truly tops off our food tour here today in Iloilo City. Can't get enough of that coconut. That does it for our food tour here in Iloilo City. Thank you so much for watching. The Ilonggo cuisine has been so unique and delicious. If you're interested in checking out any of the places we visited today, then go to our description box below for all the location information. If you enjoyed the video, give it a like and make sure you subscribe to our channel to come on our next food adventure with us. We're hungry to travel, and we'll see you next meal.